unboxing some kit parts. This has literally just arrived about 5 minutes ago. So I've got some nice tan seat bolts. They're nice. Now, I'm not sure what sort of condition these are in, because in the pictures that they sent me online, you can't really tell. I mean, they looked okay, but it's not really until you get them, home, that you can give them a proper inspection. Now, in case you don't know, trying to find tan seat bolts is really, really difficult. Especially ones that are in pretty good condition. So I've got these ones that have literally just arrived, right? And then I've got this one on here. Now you can see the difference in color. And this is something that a lot of people don't always think about, is when you put tan seat belts in your kit, you have to think about, or you have to remember, that not all of these are the same shade of tan. You see, that one that I got last week, well, I got this a few days ago, that's a slightly darker tan than that. Look, you can just see the difference. Now, the color tan I had in my last kit was this one. However, I think this is more of like a beechwood sort of color. But still, I mean, I got these because some guy was selling like a load of parts. So I thought, well, I might as well just buy them. They came with some seats and all sorts. So I'm just in the process of giving these a little bit of a clean. So these are the ones that I'm probably going to keep spare. They just need a good clean. You see, look on there. That just needs a good clean on there. A little bit of a wire brush, a little bit of a clean up. But these ones that have literally just arrived today, you can see the difference. Yeah, much better condition. Not really much more expensive either, to be honest. I got a fairly good deal. But you can see the belts are a bit grubby. They definitely need a good clean. And that's what I've done. I've actually just gone out and bought... I've just gone out and bought a little scrubbing brush just to give them a good clean. So what else we got in here then? This is literally a live unboxing. And I've never done it before. I think these are 1982 original armrests, so pretty good. Let's hope that their marks can come off there. I think that might just be a little bit of muck. Hopefully that'll all come off. There's no big holes in them, which I didn't think there would be, because I got sent pictures and I was quite happy with what I saw. But as I said, until you really get them home and give them a good inspection, you don't always know. So armrests there. So they're the screen accurate armrests. What else we got here? So these are the back seat belts. These actually come with the sleeves. Again, these are really hard to find in good condition. And that isn't actually too bad, is it? Wow. I'm like a kid in a sweet shop. Right, so what else we got? So it comes with these as well. That's handy. Otherwise, I was gonna have to buy some of them. The good thing is, they're the correct shade of tan. I just hope there's no massive great holes in them. There's a few little bits there. Yeah, not bad, not bad. Just want a good clean. These came out of a Trans Am that I saw on eBay. I got these from America, and I'm not even going to tell you the cost of the import and the postage. It was just ridiculous. So again, yeah, it's not bad. A little bit grubby. What else we got? It's just L trim, and we've got another belt there. So we've got both of the rear ones like that. They sit in the back. So yeah, they're not bad. And then we've got, you know, passenger and driver side. So not bad, not bad at all. I'm pretty happy with what I've seen so far. And of course the L trim. Now this was really hard to find. And look at that, that is in really good condition. That actually looks nearly brand new. Wow, look at that. So the L trim will go on my brand new door panels when they're done. Another L trim there. So yeah, not bad, not bad. So just a quick update of a live unboxing. Yeah, I've been looking forward to getting this box for about the last week. I think they sent it about 2 weeks ago. And obviously, because I'm in the UK, it does take quite a long time to get here. It has to go through customs and everything. So, yeah. So I'm going to spend a good few hours giving all this a good scrub, a good clean up. And I'm hoping that these are the ones I'm going to use in Kitt, in my current Kitt project. So there you go. Just another quick little update. Well, while I've got the video on, I might as well just open the door. I've taken one panel off like that. So what will happen is these will sit like that, and look at that, perfect. Wow, that'll sit like that. And I've already got the brackets, you see. On my last project, on my last Kitt build, if you remember, if you've watched any of my previous videos, I had to fix these because I had a 1987 car. This is a 90, and for some reason, you know, fortunately, it just came with the door panels like this. And they do, that, you know, all the different Firebirds and Trans Ams, they all have different sort of extras on them. So depending what model you have, what year, it can come with some different door panels and seats and interior and all of that. So yeah, I don't have to mess about with any of this time, which is really good, because this was an absolute pain trying to attach these to the door. I had to take the old ones off and put these ones back on my last car, if you've seen in the video. Yeah, a little bit of a pain, but there you go. Got the L trim there. Really happy with that. That looks almost brand new. So I don't know where they got that from. I thought it was off a car, but they sent me some pictures and it did look in good condition, but we'll see. Anyway, that's just the unboxing of some more Kitt parts. Still plenty more to do. So next job is to clean these belts up and get them all stored away, all ready to go in the car. So thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe if you're not already. See you in the next video.